السلام عليكم.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Everybody can hear me?
Wa alaikum assalam. Yes, sir. We
yes.
can hear you.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
All right. Very good. Open your Islamic studies book. We are doing the five pillars of Islam, and we were on Kalma-e Shahadat. So everybody open Kalma-e Shahadat now. What is the page number? 220 is the page number. 240 is the page number. The main idea we have discussed this main idea many times, and alhamdulillah, I think all of you are clear that we can only worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and cannot worship anybody else. If we call ourselves Muslims, then we have to worship Allah. If we call ourselves Muslims, then we can only worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and cannot worship anybody else. If we worship somebody else, then we are not Muslim. If we compare anybody almost equal or equal to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we are not Muslim. If we try to avoid Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and say that there was another messenger, there is another messenger, or there is somebody else also, then we are not a Muslim. This is the whole idea about the Shahadat. And we have read it also. I'm just going to go on because again there is a gap. So first you have to learn the Shahadat, that what is the Shahadat? I bear witness that there is no God except Allah. And I bear witness that Muhammad is his servant and apostle. It should be underlined. Now look at same page 240. Chapter number 4, verse number 36. Serve Allah, and join not any partners with him. Serve Allah, and join not any partners with him. So underline this. Then we have another one. Well, we have many, but Surah Ikhlas is also a certification that Allah is all alone and He does not share His powers with anyone. The Surah Ikhlas is one more time the same thing, that Allah does not share His powers with anyone. And He is all alone, capable of doing everything. So in karma, declaration of faith, you have to first learn the declaration of faith. And second part, then you have to learn two verses of the Quran. There are many verses of the Quran. Today class is also part of it, but try to learn a two new verses. So learn this chapter 4, verse number 36. And then also learn chapter 17. Verse 59, 73, and 85. It is on the second page. It says, all the messengers of Allah have conveyed the message of His unity. He said, O my people, worship Allah. You have no other God but Him. He said, O my people, worship Allah. You have no other God but Him. So this should be enough sufficient for you to cover. So these are the two verses of the Quran that you will be learning. Yes, learn them and write them both. Learn them and write them both. These two verses, learn them and write them both. See, children, you guys should be in the waiting area, you know, at 8 o'clock. Because when you come in late, you join late. And then it will be a problem for you. Now, let's see. Abdullah Hadi is here, Abdullah Atta is here, 13 children here, Ahmad Ansari is here, Aisha Khan is here. Abdullah Hadi, Abdullah Atta, Ahmad Ansari, Aisha, Aliza, Aksa, Hamna, Huzaifa, Kinza, Kissa, Muhammad Ali Ghari, Ghori, Yusra. So Alhamdulillah, we have and Hajra, 13 participants already here, very good. See, write it down, you know, wherever you want to write it down in your diary or there in your CD. Yeah, I have given you the book and you have to learn the dua istikhara in Arabic and Urdu. I have given you the book, and then in your test, you have a test. In that test, you will be writing the translation of Surah, or you will be writing the translation of Dua Istikhara. And I will listen to the Arabic part also of it. Plus, declaration of Shahadat plus declaration of Shahadat and the two verses of the Quran which I have just made you mark them. This is your test diary for Monday. Everybody clear?
Quiz diary.
Quiz diary. Okay, is your quiz diary for Monday. Now let's see. See here, Yusra, let's read the last two paragraphs. I think they were not read. Yes, Yusra, read the last two paragraphs. He is the model for every Muslim without whom we are talking about Muhammad, peace be upon him.
41.
Yes, page 241. He is the model for every Muslim. Or you can start from the second part of the declaration. Start from there. The second part of the declaration.
He is the
start
the second part of the development.
Continue. Okay, your sound is not coming.
Name what?
All right, no sound. Mohammad Ali Ghori, same thing. Start from the second part of the declaration. Yes, Mohammad Ali Ghori, start from here, the second part of the declaration. Yeah, Abdul Hadi, Mohammad Ghori is sleeping. Abdul Hadi, are you there? Read the second part. 241, page number 241, middle of the page.
Sir, the role of the prophet.
We start from this paragraph, the second part of the declaration. Muhammad is a worshipper. Up page 241, middle of the page, I think is the third paragraph, the second part of the declaration. Start from there.
The second part of the declaration. Muhammad is his servant and apostle. Muhammad is his worshipper and apostle. Shows its inseparable relation to the first. The Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, name is the name most closely associated with that of Allah. This sentence is also a constant theme of the Holy Quran. After acknowledging Allah as our master and sovereign, it is necessary to know what are his commandments, what will please him and what will incur his displeasure. For this purpose, Allah appointed Muhammad, peace be upon him, as his messenger and sent the Quran through him.
Yes, continue.
He is the model for every Muslim, without whom we would have no idea of how to confirm the truth laid down by the first part of the declaration. To believe in him as messenger of Allah means to accept his authority as the respect as the representative of the supreme ruler and to follow his example. He is the link between the creator and the creatures. Therefore, to deny the second part of the declaration will be to cut off all connections with the first. The declaration that Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is Allah's messenger is a proclamation of belief in the complete and final guidance that he brought for all humanity. It is also a statement of intention to follow that guidance faithfully. This declaration prepares human beings to reflect upon Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, teachings and encourages them to follow his path. The Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, summed up all the previous revelations. Therefore, to follow him is to follow the teachings of the prophets. He is a symbol of the message of Allah, of that religion, which was preached by all the prophets. The religion he was given to preach was Islam in the form of a complete system covering all aspects of material and spiritual life of mankind. He led his life according to the commandments of Allah and showed the Muslims the way to lead their lives. So when we recite the second part of the declaration, therefore Muhammad, peace be upon him, is his worshipper and apostle. We undertake to follow the law and system shown by him.
Very good, thank you. So understand this is the whole idea. What is the whole idea? That we have to obey Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. We cannot make things on our own. We cannot make our own religion. It is the Prophet, peace be upon him. He brought us the religion. His name was Muhammad. He was the worshipper of Allah and he was the messenger of Allah. All the declaration, Wahi through Wahi, Jibreel, Amin, he brought all this information to us and Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, gave it to us. This is why again and again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, repeated this verse again, that obey Allah, obey his messenger. Obey Allah, obey his messenger. And the messenger is Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also declares in the Quran at several places, kama qala qal, we have not sent any destruction to any community. We have not sent any destruction to any community until and unless we have sent a messenger to warn them against the bad thing that might happen to them. So we have to understand this, that it was again and again proclaimed by the messenger of Allah that we have to, it is not just one messenger. Since the time of Adam alayhi salam until the completion of all message with Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, All messengers of Allah gave the same message. Worship Allah. Worship Allah alone. And there is no one worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And with the last prophet, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, it is declared that he is the worshipper and messenger of Allah, or you can say apostle or prophet, whatever you like. Last part is, after Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, there is going to be no more message. There is going to be no more instructions. If somebody comes to you and they tell you that, you know, I saw in the dream that recite Surah Fatiha 27 times and this is going to be very beneficial because Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, came and told me this, he is a liar. Why? Because Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is not going to come to his dream and guide him some extra guidance. Because this is extra guidance. If reciting Surah Fatiha 27 times was extremely good for me, he would have told it to the Sahaba Karam Ajmaeen when he was alive. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is no longer alive. He is not going to come to you and bring you a new message. So whoever is going to misguide you, and this part is repeated again and again and again in the Quran, that more or less meaning Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was a human being just like you. In another place it was repeated, kama qala qal, that if your prophet is going to die, are you going to turn back on your heels? Meaning, are you going to go back to your old religion? So this is something we have to understand. That Quran is the last message of Allah, and always summarize all of this thing with a simple idea. Quran is for you. Quran is for you. Quran is for you. Quran is for me. Quran is for everyone. We have to read the Quran. If we are not going to read the Quran with translation, we are never going to get the full benefit out of it. There are thousands of people who are dying and have died. There are thousands of people who are dying and they have died without knowing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said. So I know you are going to encounter many, many, many difficulties when you're going to tell people to read the Quran. See, all these firqas and all these madahib will finish and end if we start worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At the deathbed, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, also said, and another place also he said that there will be no more messengers. I am the seal of the Prophet. And I am the last brick in a beautiful building that has been established called Islam. If you all remember, the Khatib al-Nabiyyin is a title given to Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. This title is not given to anybody else. And understand one more thing, I am explaining something to you. Very good. There's another Mufti, he is explaining something to you. Okay, still good. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking to you through Quran. And he is explaining something to you. So always remember that the explanation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the best. What I say is my understanding. What another Mufti says is his understanding. But the words of Allah are in the Quran. And there will be some people who will be misguiding you. There will be some people who will be misguiding you. Well, how they will misguide you? They will say, no, this doesn't mean this. Nahin. They will say, this verse means something else. This verse means something else. But we have to go with the most obvious meaning. We have to go with the most obvious meaning. This person who is a A, B, C, D, dash, he is telling you the meaning of the Quran which are not written there, but he is saying these are the meanings. Telling if these are the meanings, then only you know that those are the meanings. Leave me alone. Because Allah has made it simple and clear. It is given in a simple language. All the people of Arabia, they spoke Arabic. The predominant language of Arabia was Arabic. So this is why the Quran came in Arabic. Now, you want to get the complete 100% understanding of the Quran, then okay, fine, then learn Arabic. When you're going to learn Arabic, then you can be 100% sure of what is being said. So until you learn Arabic, third time I'm repeating this, until you learn Arabic, take the help of the translation of the Quran. Because this is the most quickest and the easiest way to learn Islam. And we can only stay on the straight path. Imagine it like this, that if you are, you know, 17 times you are talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you are saying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, guide me to the right path, the path of the people with whom you are happy with, and not to the path with whom that you are unhappy with. And you are saying this again and again and again and again with understanding. In the beginning of Surah Fatiha, you are saying, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. All praises are for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Rabb of the Alameen. Alameen is not just one dunya, it is not just one earth, it is not just one galaxy. Alameen means all galaxies. All stars and all earths, which we know and we don't know, which we know and which we do not know. It is all part of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's creation. So this is why we all have to understand this and follow it. And now if you have any questions, go ahead and ask me. Ajra is asking the question that we started the Khalifa Umar radiallahu ta'ala now and his conquest. Are we going to finish it? So the answer is, first we are going to do the five pillars of Islam. After we finish the five pillars of Islam, if we have time left, then we are going to do Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala now and the other three Khalifa also. Any other question, anyone? Adil Sajid class is ending. It has almost ended. In another 3 minutes, I am going to end the class and you are joining us at this such late time. This is very bad. You should be in the waiting area at 8 o'clock. You should be in the waiting area at 8 o'clock. This is the time of the start of the class. You cannot join the class at 8:42 when the class is ending. See, we have told you there will be two periods. So first one will be starting around 8 o'clock. You know, with the connection and all these problems, it is not necessary the class will automatically start at 8 o'clock. But it will start somewhere around 8 o'clock. Then, I'm going to end the class and I'm going to put this on the YouTube for all of you to go and I'm going to label it Kalmai Chadar. Okay, so we are going to label this as Kalmai Chadar and then it will be available on the ACE School YouTube channel also. Anyone else, any other question? Aksa, your sound is not coming in. What do you want to say? Write it in the chat box. Aisha sent me a question that what is the meaning of commandments? What is the meaning of commandments? The meaning of commandments means orders of Allah. Orders of Allah. Commandment means the orders of Allah. That how Allah directed us to do something. The orders of Allah. Okay, the quiz diary. Okay, let me repeat the quiz diary. We have to, I've been telling you for more than 2-3 months that learn the Dua Istikhara. So you have to learn the Dua Istikhara in Arabic and in Urdu. And the Urdu translation, you should be able to write it down also. And then learn the Kalmai Shahadat in Arabic and in English. And then I pointed, okay, then I said that learn the verse number. Chapter 4, verse 36. Serve Allah and join not any partners with him. And I said learn chapter 7, verse 59, 73, 85. He said, oh my people, worship Allah. You have no other God but Him. So learn these two. This is the quiz diary for Monday. Now take out your English books also. We are going to end the class. And inshallah, we will meet again after 15 minutes. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.